know what you're thinking. Why is Chanel, the goddess of fashion and telling it like it is, being tormented by fatties with bad haircuts and horrible shoes? What was the outrage that was so enormous it brought students back to campus despite the fact that a serial killer is still on the loose? If you believe it, it's all because I chose to pen the missive to end all missives. Attention all useless Kappa sluts. Congratulations! If you're reading this,
it means you've overcome the limitations of your tiny manatee brains and opened an email. Now, if you're asking yourself,
dear, wait, I'm confused. Is Chanel talking to me? Am I a useless Kappa slut? Simply ask yourself the following question aloud.
Is my name Chanel number 3, Chanel number 5, Chanel number 6, or Zadie Williams?
Because if the answer to that is yes, then felicitations, this missive is for you.
So, do you all remember when we agreed to meet at the campus pool and kill the dean, and I got you all awesome new phones so that when it came time to meet, the phone would light up a certain color, and when it did, you didn't even have to answer it. You just had to come meet at the aforementioned pool. And then, do you remember not coming to the pool, despite me making it super easy for you by concocting a plan so simple that an orangutan could have figured it out? Like, literally, a circus ape of moderate intelligence could have looked down at the phone sticking out of the single pocket in the front of his comical lederhosen and seen it light up and used his short little legs to waddle over to his tiny motorized Shriner's car and driven to the pool like I asked. Do you remember any aspect of this super simple plan? That's not a rhetorical question. I'm literally asking if your tiny slut brains have the power to process any of my super simple orangutan level instructions. Because what I remember is that none of you showed up, which meant I had to sit at that stupid pool by myself like a grade A asshat with a bag full of enormous chains to drown Dean Munch with and then have a super awkward combo with her where I was like, oh, dear, I just like bringing enormous chains to pools. And I look like a total div. I don't entirely know what you whores could have been doing that was more important than helping your chapter president drown a serial killer, but unless that thing you were doing was getting enemas of pure liquid gold at a new local establishment called Liquid Gold Colonics for Young Sluts, like if you were doing literally anything else, you all should seriously consider doing the human race a favor and getting sterilized. I'm not being facetious. I literally think you should consider undergoing a surgical procedure to remove your ovaries, thereby sparing human race exposure to your DNA. You four trollops are the worst specimens of human beings ever born, and you all should really watch your backs, because if this serial killer targeting Kappa House doesn't chop off your heads, I'm gonna do it so I can sell your tiny whore brain pants to science. Sincerely, Chanel Oberlin. So the next day, I went to get an extra hot pumpkin spice latte.
And more news coming from Wallace University, where an alleged serial killer continues to stalk the campus.
And that's when it happened.
After an insane sorority rant from Kappa Kappa Tau President Chanel Oberlin, students have returned to...
Is President Obama a total div? Chanel Oberlin's malicious...
The new face of hate, Chanel Oberlin...
Weighs in on liquid gold colonics.
No.
Oberlin is being labeled worst person alive.
How did this happen? Culture, but not when I'm the one getting shamed. I wanted to be famous, but not like this.
Chanel, what does it feel like to be the most hated woman in America?
What about an apology, Chanel?
Ms. Oldman, any comment at this time?
Yes, I would like to comment to all the so-called mainstream media, including weird websites that nobody has heard of who've used my name as clickbait. And to all the relentless, unwashed hordes on Twitter who have taken every opportunity to mock and attack me mercilessly from the safety of their stained futons, I offer the following heartfelt sentiment. You can all suck it! Despite my outward bravado, I was dead inside. In my heart, I knew my glamorous reign of terror was over. It was going to be difficult, but I knew what I had to do. I have to kill myself.